Rosie Finch, and this is my villa. We're getting ready for a bath. Yeah, she doesn't like it. I know there are some dogs that do, but my little girl doesn't. Now I've adjusted the water temperature so it's lukewarm. Tested on my hand, and I think it's a little bit warmer. I spray all over the body but I don't do the head at this time. For those that are new at this, it might be a good idea to put cotton batter in the dog's ears if you think you're going to spray in it there. Now, as you can see, I'm using recycling bin as her tub. I repurposed it. Works really well. I have a piece of shelving stuff so she won't slip. There's a couple of holes in the bottom so the water drains out. And this, I use my rain jacket for to keep dry. It's an excellent choice, but you don't have a rubber apron, and I don't. It's by far the best that I have found. Now, the first thing I probably will do is get a little, I have my shampoos already here. This blue one is called Feel Better. It's Matala's product I ordered online. But you can use any. Oh, this doesn't want to come out of there. I do have a rear end because I'm going to squeeze her anal glands. You don't probably want to do this, but I find it, for me, it's necessary sometimes. And she has a little bit of crap in there. Then I take more shampoo. I use a lot of shampoo. And rub it all over her body. Just rub it in good. There you go. There are many good shampoos out on the market. I use this. It's supposed to be good for humans and dog skin. And she does have a skin condition, so I try to find something that works for that. It does have a scent. It does have a scent, and I am allergic to scent. So I rinse it out really well, and then I use a bar type for the second wash. There you go. Everything is very slippery. All that soap. This is a very good shower head. I wish it had a shut off more. So it's just as a water saver. But it has a I hardly have the tax on at all. And make sure when you're doing this to not get any water in your ears, maybe, especially if you don't have cotton batten in them. And up the nose too is a kind of a bad spot. Not pleasant to get water up your nose. Jacket is a really great thing. And no, the bar soap. I wet it good first. The other thing I do is, which is unusual, but I found I can do get more shampoo on if I sit down. And I sit down and do this bar soaping part on my lap. This is a, I forgot the name of it. I get from Metro Pet in Regina. It's a bar soap, as you can see. But it busts up really nicely, but it's easy to rinse out. It's so easy. It leaves no residue at all. I really like it. It's a little rough on the dog, I think, because it's, you know, hard bar. And I usually work fairly quickly, so I need to admit that I can be a little bit, you know, harder on her. We'll do that little bum again. That. There we go. With your face. And your head. And I pay particular attention to the ears because sometimes the ears are greasy. And then there we go. There we are. Yeah, I do go fairly quickly also. She doesn't like the bath, so I try to get it over with as quickly as possible. And, nobody can see you, baby. Yeah, look at, we were too low down. I was just doing this, and I used the bar all wetted if it needs more wet water. And don't need this anymore. use my own conditioner, and it's all scented. So, again, there are lots of dog conditioners out there that you might prefer to use. I do dilute it because I use so much, put quite a bit on. Shake it up really well, and make sure it's all. Oh. Gotta get it on all of everywhere because this makes it so much easier when you're grooming. Blowing dry and combing her out. I put so much on, I have to get take it all off. It takes a little longer for that, but I like the finished look. Finished. Turn off the pot. Great. Wipe off the head first. Use all my old towels. Soak up the water. I tip this over so that they drain. Oops. Well, up. That's her bath. Talk to you on the other side while we're blow drying. Bye now.